Continuing from the previous video, this video shows you how to use some basic shaders on ice particles. To start, let's change the shape to sphere to reflect the pollen shape. Let's take a look at the default shaders that are used on the particles. Press Q and draw a render region. You can see the shader connections for the point cloud in the render tree view. Press the 7 key to open it. By default, the Phong surface shader is connected to the point cloud's material node, just like any other object in Softimage. You can use any type of surface shader on particles to render them as solid surfaces. For example, if you're using instance geometry as the particle shape, you'll want to do this. The particle color is coming from the Phong shader, which is currently the default gray. However, if you want to use the particle display color for rendering, you can bring it into the render tree by using the color attribute shader. The attribute shaders use data from the particle's attributes that are currently being used in the point cloud's ice tree. In this case, we're using the particle's color attribute as the data for driving the diffuse color of the Phong shader. The point cloud is using the default scene material, which is automatically assigned to any new object in the scene. We wouldn't normally add the color attribute shader to the scene material because the attribute shaders are used only by ice particles. We just wanted to quickly show how to use the particle's color for rendering. Now, we'll use the particle volume shaders, which let you create effects such as smoke, fire, fog, or as in our example, fluffy things. First, we'll need to increase the particle size. An easy way to do this in our setup is to simply increase the multiplier value in the Modify Particle Size node. When you're rendering particles as volumes, there's a lot more transparency on the edges in order to create a less solid look. This requires a bigger particle from which you can carve the volume's shape. Back in the render tree, let's take a look at the particle shaders and shader compounds. In the particles group in the preset manager, you can see the particle shaders at the top of the list. On the bottom of the list are the particle shader compounds. These compounds contain different combinations of the particle and other shaders. To build a particle volume shader tree, here's a shortcut to get you started. Select the point cloud and choose the Get Material Ice Particle Volume command from a toolbar. This automatically creates a new material node for the point cloud and plugs the particle renderer shader compound into the material node's volume port. This compound contains the Particle Volume Cloud shader, which is the main control center for the whole particle volume. It also contains the Particle Density shader, which determines the density and shape of each particle within the volume. A shader compound exposes only some of the ports of the shaders that are inside it. The Particle Shaper compound is plugged into the Shape Density port on the Particle Renderer compound. This compound contains the Cell and Fractal Scalar shaders, plus some other math nodes that help you shape the individual particles. Let's start setting some basic parameters. We'll focus on only a few of the main ones that affect our pollen. We'll start with the Particle Renderer Shader compound, which controls many basic settings. It's a good idea to set the overall density of the volume first with the Global Density setting. We'll make the particles look fluffy, but still fairly dense. The Particle Renderer compound uses the particle's color attribute by default. However, you can override it by selecting this option and then defining a new color as you like. Some settings that are an important part of the volume rendering process are found on the Volume Rendering tab. These settings have a big impact on both the rendering time and quality. The detail level determines just that, how much detail in the rendered volume you want to see. Set it to default for previewing, then to high for final rendering. The cell size is very important to the memory used for rendering and the quality of the render. You can see the cells when there is no interpolation between them. A higher cell size provides less detail, while a smaller value provides more detail and requires more memory. You may need to increase either the memory limit or the cell size if you get red blocks in the render. The interpolation determines how well the cells are blended together. Cubic and full light trace are more accurate and slower, but are only necessary for certain types of detail. Linear is the simplest and fastest method and is often good enough for basic volumes, as in our example here. And for previewing quickly with less detail, you can select the Enable Fast Preview for Region option. Now let's shape the particles a little bit in the Particle Shaper compound. This compound combines three shaders that create irregular shapes, cell shapes, and fractal shapes. A useful tool for seeing only the shape's pattern is the preview window. Click the V button on the shader. The default fractal options are fine for what we need, but you could adjust them to create less dense particle effects like clouds, nebula, or fog. The cell shape is what we want to set. It creates a cell-like texture that is applied to the particle. We'll set the intensity to 1, which gives some dark and light contrast. Now we'll set the texture scale to 9. This is how the cell texture pattern is scaled on each particle. The irregular shape is actually set by a fractal scaler shader under the hood. That shader has a large scale and very high contrast settings. We'll set the intensity of the irregular shape to 0.5. By changing just a few values, we have created some fluffy looking pollen. In this video, we showed you how to use shader compounds, but you could also build your own shader tree from scratch, as we'll do here. As you can see, we're using many of the same shaders that you've already seen within the particle shader compounds. Building your own tree gives you more control because all the shader parameters are exposed, but you do need to spend some quality time getting to know them. Notice that the particle's color attribute is not used by these shaders by default, so you'll need to define it with the color attribute shader. So that's it for ice particles. Now that you know some of the basics, you can start exploring and building your own fabulous particle effects.